Hi there. Me and my friend Cameron have lately been on a trip to New Zealand, and we thought that the best way to document this trip was by documenting it. So, we're going to take you on a tour of New Zealand, in our kind of style, in our kind of manner, a little bit different than everyone else's. Thanks for coming along.
I just need to add one thing. It's going to be loud.
What time is it?
Nearly even 9 o'clock.
Nearly even 9 o'clock. As if, like, it's nearly even 10 o'clock. But it's not, because it's nearly even 9 o'clock.
9 o'clock.
We're just walking down... What street is this? Oh, Stella Artois Street.
Yeah.
To get to our wicked campervan place, where we'll be staying in our wicked campervan. This is Christchurch, by the way. Just a brief look around. Quite a small city, thought it was going to be a bit bigger, but yeah, so just picking up our wicked camper van and then off we go! Okay, this is our wicked camper van. These are the designs, green stuff, wicked on the front, and that's Cameron, my chauffeur there, and Skulls. Right, I'm going to get in, make sure that's unlocked. Personally, I don't like the design, but I'm going to say I like it to keep Cameron happy. Hi there. Is it on?
I think so, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, Orlando has Disney World. Paris has Disneyland. Asterix World in Paris.
It's Legoland in London.
Legoland. There's lots of different worlds. Islands of Adventure, that's not world.
Aqua World.
The only reason we came to New Zealand, right, was for Salmon World. You can't see it, but that is a sign for Salmon World. And look at that bad boy right there. Look at that salmon. That's unrealistic if ever I've seen an unrealistic salmon. So, we're just gonna have a quick pic with the salmon. Is that... it's quite scary. Looks more like a monster than anything, but... That looks fantastic. I actually really want to go to Salmon World, but... Huh?
There's a... pricing for Salmon World. So I'd like to meet the person that paid $12 to go watch a 4D movie about salmon.
You know what? What do you think of Salmon World?
Wicked, man. Wicked. So good.
The word I'd like to use is, or two, breathtaking. Okay? Salmon World was an experience that no one's ever
there were like loads of just salmon.
It was
so good.
First there was Salmon World, then there was Sea World, okay? Right, so I'm going to write a stern letter of complaint to SeaWorld that they just don't focus on salmon enough. Like, I know there's dolphins and there's killer whales and stuff, but salmon just don't get the rap that they deserve. I mean, look how many things salmon do. Like, dolphins save people's lives. Salmon...
August 26th.
Salmon are pink. So, it's just amazing, isn't it? So, what do you like about salmon after going to Salmon World?
I just like the way they swim.
Yeah.
It's just so magical.
Yeah. It is like every other fish, but in kind of a different way. Bloody hell! This map is so big, it's a bloody scale drawing of the world! So, we're here at the Moraki Boulders. You can go in front of me. We're here at the Moraki Boulders. And so, they were designing a place to house all the Moraki Boulders information, like they're around, that's pretty much Moraki Boulder information. And the architect that they got in, they were like, look, how should we build this gift shop for the Moraki Boulders? Like that! Moraki Boulder style! They pretty much look like Moraki Boulders. If I was flying over the top and I looked down, I'd be like, is that the Moraki Boulders? No, it's a gift shop. Lads. Our New Zealand, get your boulders out for the lads! And she did, kids. And she did. Oh mate, that bird you got off with was so hot. She was fine. Damn! If I told you the reasons why, why is your top off in the van?
I don't really know.
Just Cameron started doing this thing in the van where he's where he takes the top off whenever I'm looking at him. And he's trying to come on to me.
Sorry guys.
Usually, if a piece of paper rips, I get a staple, and I staple it.
I'm going to staple it together and call it bad what?
Bad weather.
Bad weather and call it bad what?
Bad weather.
Bring it together and call it bad what?
Bad weather.
Bring it together and call it bad what? Bad what?
Second day in New Zealand? Third morning. Today's bungee jump day. We went out last night to Queenstown. Lad night. And so we're just recovering now. We're cooking up a storm over there. I'm having soup, Cameron's having rice. And I'm gonna eat this apple, but I'm feeling really rough.
Callum, what happened to your apple? Looks like Fruit World over there.
We're just pretending to our friends that we actually went on the boat.
It's too cold for one of us today, isn't it?
Yeah.
$90 here for a 40-minute ride.
It's
fun, but it's just too cold. I am too cold.
Oh, here, Cameron. What did one statue say to the other? Hi, Cameron. How are you feeling today?
I'm a little bit nervous, really.
Oh, why are you feeling nervous?
I think we've got this kind of like bungee thing.
Uh-huh, yeah.
And like, I've already peed myself a couple of times.
Oh, really?
Yeah, but you can't tell anyone that.
Oh, that's a lie. That's bone dry in your crotch area. I don't believe you.
Just ladding it up, really.
Okay. How many people have you seen die on a bungee jump?
I think there's... I've seen 20.
Okay, you're a liar. I've seen eight bungee jumps and 7 other people died.
I've seen 8 bungee jumps and 20 people died.
That's dangerous.
I know.
Are you not nervous? Are you not nervous about the bungee jump right now? You should be. You're acting a bit too cool.
I'm a bit of a lad, really. I could never
show. Lads.
You are catching yourself.
No, I'm still not.
Good? Yeah, that's good. No, it doesn't look that high.
I might get nervous like when
it doesn't look that high.
Now so you, on the other hand, are papping yourself to the max. Cameron, we were in the toilet and Cameron started crying. Crying real tears.
No.
Lad! lads! Right, sorry.
And it's showtime.
Do it, Cameron.
Two, one, see ya.
Oh my goodness. Oh my god. He's gone. So Cameron left the bath running.
Sorry, guys.
You're about to see, like, we are in so much trouble right now, cause do you see that? Probably not. There. Yeah. He flooded Queenstown.
It's all underwater.
Like, it's all under, pretty much.
Oh my god.
The modern day Atlantis. The modern day Atlantis.
I'm so sorry. I don't think anyone's going to be able to come to Queenstown.
I don't think anyone. Look at that, Cameron. Look at it. It's everywhere. It is just everywhere.
Scrag's going to do some crazy off-roading.
Okay.
Don't try this at home, kids. Let's go. Ah! Ah! Ah!
To show the beauty of New Zealand. Look at that. God. Check how clear the water is as well. So this was formed in 2002 when Optimus Prime came down and a lion.
Really cold though.
Yeah.
Really cold. A couple of degrees.
And those guys that just drove past us in the car went like that. We also have a new frame and it goes, that guy's really New Zealand. That means he's really nice because everyone in New Zealand is by the nicest people in the world.
Yeah. Walking back to the van. Yo, Callum, I just got one question for you.
What?
What did one statue say to the other?
I don't know, what did they say?
Statue, bro!
We're in Haast right now, a famous New Zealand town. It's Auckland, Christchurch, Queenstown, and Haast. And we're just checking out the place, looking at the coming attractions. Pretty busy, so we've got a lot to do. And a little time to fill it all in with.
The car park's pretty full right now, so...
Yeah, we're just about to go into the cafe and we really should have made a reservation, so we feel a bit embarrassed.
We're not in the middle of nowhere right now.
So right now we're in the middle of nowhere, trying to find a campsite on a random road. We're at one campsite, but we couldn't be bothered paying $30 to stay. So we thought, oh, let's just drive for a little bit and there must be like a random campsite at the side of the road. So far, that wasn't the best idea.
Didn't see anything.
Not looking good. Cameron, are you worried?
Yeah, I'm quite worried. We haven't really seen anything. Nothing at all.
Yeah.
May as well just be blind or something.
Yeah.
That's the end.
We may as well just be driving with a blindfold on. You can't even see the road. So we're just driving and turning once in a while.
Yeah.
We think it's quite fun actually.
Yeah.
But
it's really alright so far.
If we get to the campsite, we'll catch up. Yeah.
Quarter to nine.
It's quarter to nine. And we have come for a wee walk to the Franz Josef Glacier. There it is. Massive glacier. Just
isn't
so
incredible.
Impressive. It's just like, I'm going to go home to Aberdeen, dig a hole in the garden and pour some water out and put an ice cube in and call it the McEwan-Whyte Glacier. Just get people to come and walk for ages for a pointless thing. It is quite beautiful though. Not actually that bad looking.
It's quite nice.
Maybe it's an HFFA, hot from far away. Apart from not, because it's a glacier, so it's cold.
Hot from far, but far from hot.
Hot from far, but far from hot, mate. And, yeah, Franz Joseph, as everyone knows, was Hitler's brother. He came to Australia and started up his own Nazi regime. But they like to keep that quiet, because they don't like... Because the reason it was named the Franz Joseph Glacier is because it's white, so that's why.
Nazis white.
Nazis and white, they go together everywhere.
And it's also retreating like the Nazis.
Yeah, it's retreating like the Nazis. Yeah! Have at ya!
So we thought we'd document this this road, because it's pretty intense.
Yeah.
It's pretty intense right now, but as soon as we start videoing, I guess straight again.
Which, you know what? It's our luck.
Just our luck.
Just our luck.
But it's pretty intense.
Joel. Just our luck.
Pretty good views, though.
Yeah. Really? Yeah. Up and down.
It's not like a roller coaster this road.
It wouldn't be, I wouldn't pay to get on this roller coaster.
No. Probably not.
No.
Only pay for
birds of New Zealand. Right, mate? Take a video, I'll speak to him. I can speak birds. So we've decided to pick up two hitchhikers on the side of the road because we're nice guys. We're going to pick them up because we're nice guys and we're going to see where they're going and take them there. So we picked up the two hitchhikers that we drove past earlier and they're in the back right now.
Say hi, guys.
Hey.
What are your names, by the way? We didn't ask.
I'm Jake Nichol.
Jake
Nichol. Cody Wright.
Cody Wright. Okay, so they haven't killed us yet, which is good. We're gonna go to Nelson and they might like knife us or something there, but it should be good. And then from Nelson we have no idea where, but yeah, we've survived.
Rad messy night tonight.
Yeah, rad messy night.
Rad.
So yeah, that's it. Lad.
Cameron started chatting about his diabetes, so all the sheep are bombing it. Yeah? So, just at Picton, probably the best place in the world after Nelson. And we've got 2 hours to kill before we go on the bus, and we're better to spend
the bus, the ferry.
The ferry.
It's up there, man.
We're better to spend it than Picton, you know. And we just stopped off at the museum, which, in case you're thinking of running a museum, and just before you think of that, that's a bad idea, because let's be honest, museums are boring. The best location for a museum, which we found out, is between two public toilets. So, male and female, and female is also disabled, so it's good like that. But so build a museum, either build a museum between two public toilets, or build a museum, then build two public toilets on the side, too. Either way, it works.
What are we doing right now?
Chilling.
Waiting for the ferry, actually.
Waiting for the ferry, sorry.
Just for chilling.
Fucking lad.
Oh, yeah, we found out that only lads are allowed on this ferry.
Only lads.
So you had to do a lab test where they put what was the lab test again?
They put like loads of birds around and you had to pick three large birds.
Yeah, and then get with them at the same time.
Three of them at the same time.
I got with the 8 hottest birds, so that's how Cameron was allowed to go.
From my reflection, I
Hey Cameron.
Yo.
So we just arrived at the international airport. And there's actually, you'll probably see it on the news back in the UK, there's actually been a plane crash, which has happened just right there. So that's a bit awkward, because...
We're videoing it.
Yeah, we're videoing it. This is breaking news, plane crash. Look, that's the wheels just landed perfectly on that steel barrier. That's pretty lucky, though.
Pretty lucky.
It doesn't look that messed up, either.
Yeah.
Don't know where the pilots are. There's been a kayak crash over there. That's savage. That's savage.
So this is the international airport.
Yeah, this is the international, massive international airport.
They fly all over the world, really, over here.
Yeah, because it's international, not intranational.
No.
Now, how's that? International. Not intranational.
It's not racist to call Chinese people singing, is it? Put the window down.
You have a lot of dangerous drivers who go too fast and just can't control their speed. Far too fast. Right now, we're driving behind one and we need to document this. Slow down!
Mayday!
You're gonna flip the car! You're gonna flip the car! Oh my god!
Oh my god!
No, this is too fast!
Oh my god!
Oh, this is too fast! That's the sky, that's what we'll be in.
Land. We're gonna be in the sky.
We're gonna be in the sky. Some people dive into swimming pools. No. We dive into the sky.
Yeah.
And we don't know what will happen when we dive into the sky. Like, I don't know how we're gonna land.
I don't think I'm gonna save my parachute.
They said parachutes are optional when you jump out of the plane. They said, and like, I just don't think I'm gonna save my parachute because I'm a bit of a lad. Are you a bit of a lad as well?
Yeah, I don't think I'm gonna save my parachute. Fall on some shit.
I wouldn't like to fall on some shit. I'd rather fall on a field away from shit. But Cameron likes that kind of stuff. So I'm gonna see if this works, right? In 3 seconds, we're gonna be in the parachute area. 3, 2, 1.
Video. We're waiting to be served, so it's really awkward. You probably see us filming this.
Are you nervous yet, Cameron?
No.
Neither am I. Me and Cameron don't feel fear anymore.
Jumping out of a plane,
you know. No parachute. Cameron. Lads. Cash. Hey, Cameron? Cameron? You up for a... I'm kind of up for doing a skydive today.
Yeah, I'm cut.
Just a little bit.
You're on
a little bit.
You're on record.
So maybe like 2 ice cubes instead of 5.
So dudes, we pretty much drunk that liter vodka.
This is gonna be on the grandparents.
It's the most rank vodka in the world.
It does taste like
but
shit.
But we are drinking it like an chug. We're outside Lava Bar, and we're just about to get some cash, but,
there's Lava Bar,
we're having a lad night!
It's so nearly his birthday! So, watch children, because he's already intimidated.
Yeah, there's some children.
Okay, first left, okay?
No, 8:30 at night, is it? 8:30? 8:30?
Right, anyway,
and we are,
let's get lad out. 1, 2, 3,
lad out.
Hey Cameron.
Hi.
Guess whose birthday it is today?
It's mine.
Is it? I haven't wished you happy birthday.
I'm feeling so great right now. I feel on top of the world, literally.
You look on the bottom of the world.
I look a bit special.
You look a bit special. This is let's go to the thermal pools. But yeah, to waste some time. Yeah, but anyway, so this is
Rotorua.
Holiday park!
Thermal holiday park! Yay! Everywhere you look, there's a holiday! Yay! So, I've got the surprise, Cameron's birthday surprise planned for him. Thought I had messed it up. Thought I'd booked it on the wrong day, but I called up. Everything's fine. It's gonna be a big birthday surprise, isn't it?
Uh-huh.
And I've given him some hints. There might be a party and everyone's flying into it. Everyone's flying from Scotland.
Gonna have a sardine.
Just gonna have a sardine.
Gonna have a sardine.
Okay. That's our esky, by the way. Full of healthy food.
It doesn't smell bad. Trust me, it doesn't smell bad in there. Really doesn't smell bad in there.
But yeah, lads. Lad out?
Lad out.
Callum? Callum, why are you looking at the wellies?
This is going to be knee-deep in cunts.
Hey Cameron.
Hey.
So, what are we waiting for right now?
My birthday surprise from Callum.
You still don't know what it is, do you?
No, I have no idea. We're just chilling, waiting around.
I'm gonna murder Cameron. Jokes. So, are you excited about it?
Pretty excited.
Yeah?
Pretty excited. I want to know what it is. Just want to know what it is.
You can't zoom in. I'm zoomed in on your eyes right now. I want to know what it is as well. I want to know what it is.
I hope it's all my girlfriends coming over. See me.
Who's your girlfriend?
What are my girlfriends?
Oh, who are your girlfriends?
Oh, I've got loads all over the world.
Oh, sweet. That's awesome.
Just chill.
I've got about, how many girlfriends have you got?
I've got eight.
Hey, I've got 12.
You've got 12. Oh, no, I forgot about the other four.
I forgot about, so we're just counting, wait, are we counting like different countries as well?
No.
Oh no, so in different countries, what's your girlfriend?
Mine's a million.
Oh, mine's a billion, that's about, mine's the population of the earth.
6 billion.
6 billion.
Sad.
So actually 3 billion, because half of them are girls. You know what I'm saying? Right, so next time you see us, we'll be somewhere.
Pretty much.
Somewhere. So Cameron, you found out what your surprise was.
Pretty sick.
What is your surprise?
Maori experience.
Maori experience. We're eating food and we're eating Maori people. That's what the Maori experience is. And kiwi. Kiwi, but not the fruit, the bird. So what do you say for your birthday present?
Thanks so much.
Very welcome.
Lad.
Cameron, where are we right now?
Black water, placey.
Abyss.
We're gonna go
black water
abyss diving, like diving into abysses.
Interview me about the black water rafting.
So how do you feel about the black water rafting?
Good.
Feel good.
Good.
I mean, how good?
As good as Jesus.
All right.
Not
okay.
As in like I feel like I'm Jesus. Just as good as Jesus was a good guy.
So,
you know? Are
you gonna be at the front of the whole group?
Yeah. I'm leading it.
You're leading it?
Yeah, they are.
Oh, you...
Because they know that I know these kids better than anyone.
And you're like a really good instructor and stuff, so...
Well, I just kind of did half a year of outdoor education at a place called Scotch College, so I'm actually pretty good with all this stuff.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah.
There's no point even being arrogant about it, because you know you're good.
Yeah. Good point.
Yeah. Alright, cool. You saw all my pieces broke out.
So, Cameron is right now, we've just done the Blackwater rafting and it was really good, but
Right now, Cameron is in the Blackwater rafting place because he has to ask for a phone, because we need to phone Wicked Camper Vans, because Jonah, our camper van, isn't starting. It's definitely the battery, but we've already tried to jump start it with two different cars and two different jumper cables, and it's not working. So Cameron has gone inside to try and call him. We tried to call him off payphone, but the payphone was broken. We tried to call him off my mobile, but it doesn't let you call him off my mobile. So pretty comedy. Last like full day of driving, and we are stuck in the middle of nowhere. So yeah, comedy.
So Cameron, it is. That's not the actual time. No, that's not the actual time. It's like, what, six-ish? Seven?
Yeah.
4 hours. We know you can't see us. That's because we're in the dark, because we can't switch on any lights in the camper van, because we're meant to not put the battery through too much, like, power intensifiedness. We made friends with a woman who gave us free bagels and free soup while we were waiting for the jump lead person. And the car is working now, but we have to drive to Auckland, the land of Ox. It was me and you, 'cause we are gonna be forever, you and me. Always keep me flying high in the sky of love. Where are we right now? No, as in place. Auckland. Base. Youth hostel. Because we flirted with the girl heaps, and she fancied us both, mainly me. Check the free view we got. Boom. I don't know if you can see that. It's a nice view. Pretty sick head. I didn't even know that was a word, but it works. Sick head. We're staying in a room with a girl called Ivana, surname Pumpalot. But seriously, her name's actually Ivana. I'm Jackie on the way. So we're happy chappies. We're happy chappies. Interview me about what's happening tonight.
It's gonna happen tonight, actually. Yeah.
We're gonna have a lad night.
But so who are you gonna get with?
Oh, Ivana.
Well, that's what you think.
We're already sleeping in the same bed. It's a bunk bed, but, you know, it still counts.
Yeah, pretty much.
So that means I'm going to go back and say I slept with you. Called Ivana Humble.
Except for she's not called Ivana.
She's called Ivana, like, Chirka.
Imagine if she walked in like that.
I'd be like, oh, alright. Share beds.
Looking like that. Yeah, you'd look bad.
Is this Tommy? Is
that? Yeah.
I believe in you like a virgin. Say goodbye to the camper van. Well done. Let me say bye to Jonah.
It's emotional. This is very emotional. Good hug. Bye, Jonah. Something.